We have been working together already for a long time. I believe that we have become strong partners. We have had also the honor to have one of your first machines running at our facilities. And we have been able to find out how this new technology is working. Maybe can you give a bit of an insight on what the strengths are of this technology in the market?
We really appreciate all the help that Materialise has given to us. The key advantages of multi-jet fusion technology is mainly the speed and the quality of the parts and the competitiveness of the cost of the parts. So those are the key pillars of our value proposition that we have been validating with our key strategic partners like Materialise.
So in our collaboration until now, we have been developing a build processor to connect the HP multi-jet fusion printer to our software tools. What kind of value does such a build processor bring to the users of multi-jet fusion?
One of the things we wanted when we introduced multi-jet fusion is to make sure that the key software that is used today in the market was perfectly integrated with our machine, so that the user had a very easy startup with the machine. The barriers for adoption of multi-jet fusion technology were low. We believe the integration with Materialise build processor will be seamless for the people that already knows how to use Materialise, and then it will help them adopt the technology. We also believe with this integration, the people that has not been using this software or has not been using 3D printing at all, up to now will find it very easy to go from the preparing the build, the packing of the build, up to the printing and then all the quality control after that, and get the best out of the multi-jet fusion printer.
How important do you think that openness of technology is to grow the 3D printing market?
We believe openness will be key to drive the transformation of the 3D printing industry. We want to drive the growth of the market orders of magnitude, not 10% or 20%, but really transform completely the industry. And we believe there are two key components for the openness that will drive this transformation. First one is on the workflows. We believe the interoperability of the systems, all the software and all the hardware need to be connected with the same format, something like the PDF for the 2D. And the other one is on the materials. We want to change the dynamic that has been in the market up to now. We want to leverage all the innovation potential of the main material science companies in the world. We want to drive the economics, and we want to get to the point where price elasticity really kicks in and we start the virtuous cycle. The volume of 3D printing grows, the economics go down, then more and more things make sense to do in 3D printing. And we believe there is no company in the world that can do all this innovation by themselves, no matter how big the company is. And we need the whole ecosystem to work together to really transform the industry.
Do you see as well the hurdle in getting over that mindset that people think or could start thinking more in 3D and in additive? And how would you approach this?
Some of the potential barriers that we need to work together to overcome and train the world is on the limits that the traditional methodologies have put into the mechanical designers, and make sure that we can really open their minds to the limitless potential that we can have with 3D printing. And again, this is something where we need to work together as an industry to educate the next generation of engineers on that.
Thank you very much, Virginia, for this wonderful insights.
Thank you for the opportunity to share some of our thoughts.